Well, here we are at the AI Summit New York. I'm happy to say I'm joined by Chris McGlassman. Thank you very much.
Of course.
Now, you've been dealing with customer marketing strategy for a long time. What does digital strategy look like these days?
Oh, it's very complicated and up and coming, especially at the AI conference. I can say that it's very customer-centric. And what we're trying to do is do hyper-personalization. So digital strategy is all about customer centricity and how we can improve the customer experience with AI and ML.
So you've worked at a lot of major brands along the way. How have you seen it change over the years?
It has progressed. So I've worked across finance, retail, e-commerce, and there's one thing, that is American consumers. So over the years, we have learned to train our models, train our data, to be able to serve the customers better.
So when you go into a company, do they get this? Or do you have to really educate versus bringing in technology?
I think it's more and more people are getting it. There is a lot of awareness around data, artificial intelligence, machine learning. What we need to really work on is data. So there is, on the business and technology side, both, there has to be a level of comfort to working with each other, and that translation of business outcomes to technology deliverables.
So if a company says we need a better digital strategy, where do they start?
I think they should start with the customer itself. What do they want to really serve the customer, and what business outcomes they're trying to drive with that strategy.
And are different industries different?
I believe so. The kind of data they collect, the regulations, the industry patterns, the customer behaviors are different across different industries for sure.
So are there some that are easier than others, like say retail versus financial services versus industry?
I would not say easier, but they're different in their own way. I mean, retail and e-commerce, it's mass market, there are lesser regulations, so you're able to collect and target very differently. Where in finance, there's more data available. There's a lot of transaction data, there's a lot of credit card, banking data, but there are a lot of regulations. So different strategies for different, you know, different strokes for different folks.
Right. So what if it's a B2B company?
Even B2B, it is different because now you're not targeting or you're not giving products to on a very small ticket. These are higher ticket value items, so you have to be hyper targeted in your offering.
So I understand you're looking at joining Visionaires. What is that about?
I've recently heard about it. So thank you for introducing me to Visionaires. I believe it's a round table of like-minded professionals in New York City who can huddle and talk about challenges and opportunities and learn from each other. And I'm all about lifelong learning.
So if in the future, you've been doing this for a while, through digital transformation, how do you see it changing going forward?
I've been doing it for 15 years and more.
Starting to get the hang of it?
Yeah, I'm still getting the hang of it. Every day is a new day, Chuck. So learning on the job, learning on the fly, understanding people's problems, customer problems, business problems, complex problems, and solving for it. So I think the problems would continue to evolve, and the solutions are getting better and better.
So what are some of the biggest challenges companies face in terms of customer interactions?
I think the biggest challenge companies face is in terms of data. So we all talk about strategy, we talk about AI models and all the good stuff, but if your underlying data layer is not in a good shape, it's not organized, the platform itself is not organized, and the strategy itself won't work.
So if we're having this conversation a year from now, what would we be talking about?
I think we'll be talking about how we're trying to change the world with AI.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.